He's in from Spokane, Washington. This is Jeff here. Where do you call home? You call California, Oakland home now?
Yep.
And this is Wilhelm from Pretoria, South Africa.
Morning, Miss Betsy. The birthday girl.
Yeah.
Up on the news this morning is we're having a raffle today for Mike. You've seen him on our videos before. Mike's got a cool story. He's you know, a lot of people say they watch this channel because it's inspiring, but we find Mike to be incredibly inspiring. 9 years ago on May 24th, I think he said, Mike had a stroke. And the trick to this is, if you have a stroke, try not to drive yourself to the hospital, because when he got there, they thought he was drunk, and they shoved him off onto a gurney and thought he'd get better, and he didn't. And some hours later, a nurse who wanted to do the right thing actually got to him and probably saved his life. But Mike has spent 9 years of fighting to get recovery back. And he has now made it to being able to use his right arm, and he's perfectly loosened guy nowadays, and works around in his shop in a wheelchair. And he's already done some work for us out here, and I just find Mike to be, I got two of the same kind of glasses. He's a very inspirational guy, and he's been making the deck bolts for us. There they are. And he recently had the people that he was renting the building from wanted the building back for somebody else, so he lost his lease on it. But he found another place, a little smaller, a little less money, and but it doesn't have three-phase power. So he's got all these, that lathe that I showed you in that last video with him, he paid $1 for that lathe. That's a 1942 lathe. It was and it was sitting around in somebody's shop, nobody using it, so he picked that up for $1. And so he's put together this beautiful machine shop, and he can do fantastic work again. But he's obviously getting back on his feet, and he needs three-phase power, because the shop he moved into does not have three-phase power. So worked with him, and he's picked out a unit from American Rotary Power, I think is the name of the company, and that'll pull his building. And so we're raffling off not my new knife. I'll show you my new knife in a bit. We're raffling off my old knife. I think I got this when Chris Gasson was here.
Yeah, it's not very old. You only bought it in November.
Yeah, and so I've been carrying this around. The pouch shows more wear than the knife
does.
The
DNA on that pouch.
Oh yeah, well there's a little blood on there too. So it's a tad worn mainly, and it's not nearly as sharp as it was, but it's a Leatherman. And
Surge
Leatherman. So it's
21
got
tools.
The locking blades, it's got two blades on it, and it's got the pliers on it. And it doesn't really matter, because it's not nearly worth what a three-phase power converter is, but this is just your little reward to help get you incentive to buy a raffle ticket. So all you got to do is go to our website under the junk store. You will find amongst our overpriced junk a raffle ticket for $5, and I appreciate you buying one. I think we've already sold, what?
84.
84 of them since last night.
One person bought 12.
Yeah, I know, one person bought a dozen of them. So as many as you can, but not more than what you can afford. You know, keep it within your means. And we'll get Mike set up with a, well, we found that there's a couple of guys that have found some used ones. So we've got one that's might work, that's $1,600, and another one that's $2,500. And then I actually got a deal worked out with a distributor here for a brand new unit for $4,000. So we're just going to collect as much money as we possibly can. We're going to set Mike up with an excellent unit, something that he won't burn his machines up on, so, because he can't afford to lose anything. So let's see. Now what I want, oh, I'll show you my new knife. Let me show you my new knife, because this guy here created my new knife. Now, William Buys, as he is known as, made a piece of jewelry for me years ago.
I have that here.
Oh, you do? You brought it out?
I have samples.
Cool. This is what he made for us years ago, and he is a...
Certainly could use polishing.
I know. But let me see if I hope that'll show up. Let me see. Yes, maybe. Maybe more light on it.
No, I'm still looking at...
There, it's coming. It's coming. That is... How'd you make this thing? How'd you do this sail?
Silver plate.
It's silver plate.
That's bent.
Yeah, you bent it first to give the shape of the sail.
Yes, and then the dragon was cut...
By hand?
By hand out of a piece of gold.
Gold plate?
Yeah, thin gold plate, and then carved up, and then soldered on top of the sail.
He has been working since the age of... When did you start your apprenticeship?
16.
Wow, that's 5 years.
Yeah, only 5 years, and he's this good at it.
But wait, there's more.
Oh, yeah?
And then there's, other than the lovely dinners that you took me to one in April, took me to one.
Oh,
then
yeah.
Then he gave me the only present I got, which was reminder of our trip to the Kansas City Zoo when we heard the song. Come on.
When I was a young warthog.
When he was a young warthog.
Yeah. Betsy's one of Betsy's favorites, and he happened to make this as well, which is a warthog head. He's from South Africa, so that totally makes sense for them down there, too. Beautiful work he does.
And if you turn it upside down, it looks like a scarab.
Oh, yeah?
Look at this.
Oh, it does.
Yeah.
Looks like a beetle from the back.
It does.
All right. I
so
see.
Then.
Oh, no, my knife. Yeah, the knife. So, William here.
We love hostess gifts.
Well, this is an amazing gift. I mean, this is really something special. So that's why I no longer need to carry my Leatherman around. But he put this together for me. It's his first pocket knife he's ever made. And he had a friend work on the logo there for it, but it's got our sail with the dragon on it and embossed onto the blade and put together with its copper and... What's the embedded material? Is that gold?
No, it's copper and then silver.
Copper and silver on the inside?
Yeah, the dragon is silver.
Okay, the dragon's silver and the plating around it's copper. It's a long-winded processor put together. And then William Byes was engraved in the back with a chisel and a hammer to carve the letters into it. And it has oh my God, this blade is sharp. I mean, I'm worried about it every time I get this thing out until it gets loosened up where I can open and close it. Got a hasp on it and it's called again a marlin spike, which is you'd shove it into a knot. You know, you always sit there and pick it with your fingers. This thing goes into a knot and loosens it up.
So you make a heck of an ice pick too.
Sailman tool, saber tool.
You could stab a shark with it right in the eye.
Pith the shark.
Yeah.
So a beautiful tool, and it came. I'll have to take my belt off. He also made the.
You can't get it in with the belt on. Oh.
No, it's one that doesn't fall off.
Oh.
So he made the pouch for it as well, which is three pieces of leather, all handcrafted and custom fit to the knife itself. So, and a snap to hold it in place. So that is my knife going forward. Your knife is the one you get when you win the raffle, which your odds, frankly, aren't good because we're selling as many raffle tickets as we possibly can because whatever we got left over, we'll just pass that on to Mike.
You know, I think we could sell your dirty underwear and make a lot of money.
We are not selling dirty underwear, anybody's.
Hey, what are you wearing?
I'm wearing underwear.
No, what's that shirt?
Oh, it's...
That wet shirt.
The wet shirt is...
The brand new Grinder God shirt, and you're not, I mean, I don't
I'm
know.
I'm not okay. I think I'm on camera.
You gotta stand there a while.
All right, we'll stand here a little while, see if it catches up. See, here it comes.
Oh, it's this, well, it's the light's kind of
The light
of
is
weird.
Kind of bad. Okay, here. Yeah, I'll put the camera over here by you.
Okay.
And the lighting will be better back this way.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Oh, yeah. So. Yeah, the difference between the old Grinder God shirt and this one is we've given it a spatter effect.
Yes.
Or is it splatter? What's the term?
Yeah, I think it's splatter.
Splatter.
It's spatter when it's welding. It's splatter when it's paint.
And a dripping paint look.
Yeah.
And
we improved the graphic.
Yes, it's much more artistic. And
yeah,
we have plenty of them in sizes medium to triple X right now in the store.
Cool.
Now, the bad news is we're almost out of coffee mugs, but they are on reorder.
Yeah, you guys have really snapped up those coffee mugs, so there's another case of them coming our way. And so what we're doing while it's raining outside this morning is the guys are cutting old school bus material. They were the seat covers that came off our school buses, and those are getting hacked up so we can make covers for our tools, because the tools need to sit outside, and this year apparently it's just going to rain all year long. And I'm going to walk you around the other way. I'm going to show you what we bought this week. And this is somebody's suggestion, too. I don't remember who. Oh, where'd that piece of foam go that I had down here? Oh, it's over there. Let me do another thank you here, too. I got two more thank yous to do. What do you got? Oh, he's making the... Did it fit? Oh, lovely. Yeah, this one's roomier than the older one, so we don't have to be so nice. Cool. One down. Three to go.
What are you looking for? Are you looking at gasket material? Did you?
Yeah. Craig. I'm looking for what Craig's last name is. Craig McDonald. He, Spokane Packaging, wrote me and said, do you need any gaskets? And I said, yeah, we got lots of hatches up there that need gaskets. And so we have, courtesy of Craig, industrial, not the crap you buy at Home Depot, but this is a good rubber, foam rubber stuff that with adhesive already glued to the back of it, and 1/2 inch and 3/4 inch wide strips. And I got this and two more boxes of it up in the attic now, so we are good for sealing up our hatches. You know, you gotta wait until we get the paint on, but it's gonna be well done. Have you learned to drink iced tea? It is a good thing, especially when in this hot Oklahoma, okay? Oh, wait, I got another thank you down here. This came in today. And I tell you what, I get this every once in a while. This is from Gary Burley. And Gary makes, he's showing off now, he does sewing work. Gary, you should be here today, because, yeah, we got the sewing machine running. But he made some ditty bags for us, and some belt loop tool holders. There's slots in there so you can shove knives and screwdrivers and other stuff down there. It's kind of handy, especially now that I won't carry a leather man. I might have one of these things on. And this is a clever little idea. I've never seen this. For you guys that need to carry pills and keep them dry and other little parts, he's taken the tops off of bottles, right? Two of them, identical. And he glued them together with a piece of acrylic in between them. So now he's got a salt and pepper shaker, or your pills, or whatever it is you need to carry and keep dry and watertight. Clever idea. Now, he did these for me the first time, and, you know, just as a gift, he wanted them to be on board Seeker, and I said, that's cool, but there's so many of them that I started giving away to people that pass through here, because, like, Will over there is on a motorcycle. Just like Lyle's, you drive a BMW? Yeah, we'll take you out and show you his bike. Beautiful bike. He's doing a loop tour of the United States. And these are alcohol stoves. Now, this is cool. I know I've seen these a lot of times, but I don't really have from Gary how he does this. He didn't describe it, did he?
But we don't need any more, do we?
Yeah, because I give them away.
Oh, these are, I thought he didn't like it when you gave them away.
He doesn't, but that's okay. He seems to have accommodated to it, because he sent me like another dozen of them, and I still have another six from the last batch. So, but anyway, it's gorgeous work, because look what he does. The paint's not even scratched, and somehow he's folding this can over and pressing it in. I think he's using a plastic, like an arbor press with a piece of plastic on it or something to stop from scratching the paint. But it's got little holes pierced in around the inside of the rim, and when you put a little bit of alcohol in it, the holes are. They're on the outside right there. You can barely see them. Little tiny things. And when you put alcohol in it, light it on fire, when it gets hot, the alcohol vaporizes. So when you put your pot sitting right on top of it, or your can of beans or whatever, little flames fire out of each of these holes. The whole thing is blazing hot, but it weighs nothing. It's easy to carry, and you can put your alcohol in something small. You don't need a lot of it. Heat yourself up a hot meal without carrying anything along. So thank you very much, Gary. I appreciate the resupply, as well as the, that'll be all right, as well as the ditty bags. All right, now, the rain is, hopefully it's gonna lighten up. The radar said it would. I may lose my connection here for a little bit. We'll be all right. We'll put this up on YouTube here. I'm gonna show you something else we got. This was a heck of a good deal. There's Will's bike out there. Huh, Lyle? Does that give you memories? The only thing I love about this version of it, or if I was gonna have a bike, this one has shaft drive on it. And Lyle made it all the way up to Dead Horse in Alaska. with a chain, and that was a hard thing to do because the rocks pick up in the mud and it braids the chain. You had to wait in Anchorage to get a replacement chain. Hey, Lyle, we need an update from you, buddy. I don't know, you know where you are now. Look at these things. These are, and we got them for $400, which is, by the used market, a great price. They came out of a Walmart center, and they're for unloading groceries. They actually, you know, can bend off to the side or what, and they can adjustable in height. So the idea is when we're putting the sail together is we will put the big bundle of the sail on that, and then it's easy to move it past the sewing machine. So a couple of you suggested that, and that's the one we went with, so we really appreciate that. Oh, and show you out here what Will's working on is we have our axles underneath our trailer. Yeah, I haven't mowed my grass. Stuff's growing like wildfire. You know, normally this time of year it starts to die because it's drying out. Not this year. Let me let you peek through there. The trailer out there, he is welding those axle sets onto that frame there. That's the axle set that's going to stay on that frame. So it's getting just gobs of stick welding done on it today to hold it all together. And then we're going to start moving soon. The main mast needs to be final welded in its joint. And the mizzen mast is ready to go. That's out in the backyard. The foremast is sitting out alongside the driveway. So we might start moving mast here. Okay, that's it. That's our update. What I need you to do?
Remind them again. How long we're going to be selling raffle tickets?
And we're going to be selling raffle tickets until next week. So like this time next week, and we'll be done by Saturday.
What if we make too much money?
We'll give it to Mike, and he can buy tooling with it, or he can build stuff for us for the boat. He's already got some ideas, some of the stuff he wants to build for the boat, so it'll be nice. So.
Okay. Well, we're only about 16% of the way there right now.
So. Yeah, I don't know if we'll make it all the way to there, but if not, then we'll give him what we got by next Friday, and we'll keep you updated on our Facebook page. So, yeah, if it goes really well, your odds keep decreasing. Such is life.
Okay, and we only got one more weekend, and then Lars comes on some, I don't know, the Norwegian who is so convinced it's not hot here. Oh, Lars, you are so
wrong. Yeah, we're going to prove.
I have no sympathy. And then after that, we are done working on the boat until mid-September.
Mid-September, we decided now it's been so blazing hot that we've closed down until September, which means I'll go to work on the ROV and do some inside stuff, but no more trying to get stuff done on the boat
out there. So, basically, no guests.
Yeah.
Check the calendar
starting up in
mid-September.
Love to have you mid-September, October.
Fill out the questionnaire, the questions on the Welcome Aboard page.
Go to our website to About Us.
Double, triple, quadruple booking. Read all about it.
Yeah. Okay. So thank you all very much. Any questions on there we need to answer?
Oh, Chris Faith is on here.
Hey, Chris, how you doing?
He's
the guy with the
shoelaces. And I know he would want to say thank you to everybody
that's seen
him on here. And
he's made his, what's those things called?
A button up.
Yeah, a button up is the product. He makes the shoelaces that snap on, and they, it's called a Kickstarter. Yeah, his Kickstarter made, and he's actually pushed it on past, so it made that extra gold type thing was on it. So,
and he's, I guess,
well done,
sure,
Chris.
The second one's done, but and it was nice because he's kicked into the raffle.
Oh, he is?
Yes.
Bought himself a ticket.
And we have
out.
Another one that you extended and they've kicked in. So I really appreciate this payback. This is a good deal.
Yeah, we appreciate it. You Mike's know? a worthy guy for it. You know, we don't come along with this type request too often, and it is selfish too because he's making stuff for us, and that's where we met him. But He really is just, you know, he's one of those, you know, marvelous individuals. A lot of these guys come by here and show up here. This is kind of a magnet for that type. I'm glad you found him to be inspirational, and I hope you're willing to help him out.
Now, will we do the draw live? Yes. In fact, I finally figured out how to keep track of this.
Did you?
And when you buy a raffle ticket, you get an order number. So, for example, there's somebody out there that's 5558, and if you bought four tickets, you'll have four or five 5558s in the bucket.
In the bucket.
And so when we do this, whether if it's on a Saturday morning, of course we'll do it here.
Let's do it. If we're going to do it live, let's do it next Saturday morning.
We can always do it live. We can always say we're going to draw the ticket tomorrow night at such and such a time. Yeah. So
if it's too successful, we'll cut it off.
And we will do it live on Facebook Live. So you can see this because, I mean, you want to know we don't rig it or nothing. So anyway, other than your pay, and at that point you become a number and or multiple numbers that are all the same number, and they go into the bucket.
Okay.
And that's how we're doing it.
So sounds
it's
very fair.
It is more legitimate than the Academy Awards.
Oh, yes.
In the bucket.
Okay. You can't put money in the bucket.
Well,
I'm
buying a raffle ticket.
Oh, you'd be buying a raffle ticket. Okay.
Oh, man.
With cash. That's hard to do. Can you go online and do it?
Oh, God, I hate that.
And what are you doing with American dollars anyway?
Okay, I have some questions.
South African.
All right.
Okay, Devin says take a look at the mill. Well, it's still over there and nothing's happened yet.
Yeah, I haven't done anything with the mill. I have been studying up on Fusion 360 and learning how to do tool paths on it.
Somebody asked, what about the communications on board? And let me answer this.
Okay,
we still got, a year and a half, 2 years.
Yeah.
And technology as it is changing by the day. So, our ultimate goal is we live in hope that we are going to have really inexpensive, high-speed internet anywhere we go. And
wouldn't that be nice?
You just quite don't know that yet. Now, the first year, we're probably going to be hanging pretty close to the U.S. coast.
Yeah.
So I imagine we'll be, we'll probably be AT&T daddying our way through life because it does tend to work about better than anything else in the United States right now for consistency. And but it's hard to say what we're going to do because whatever exists at the time, we will do the most that we can afford to do.
That's a good answer for it, too.
Same thing with solar panels,
radar,
any
navigation electronics, all
but
that stuff.
But that's why we're not putting money into those items yet, anything electronic and technology, because...
Not until the last minute.
Yeah.
Probably going down the river, too.
Well, you all have a good time. I'll be in the Holiday Inn with the dog.
Okay. You can do that. Okay, guys, thanks for joining us. What did you make today? Since we don't really get...